Hello, everyone. Happy week 11 for Pace Setters. I'm so excited that y'all have stayed with me this long. It's so exciting. I hope that you are seeing incredibly big results in your business. And this is the week of truth for you guys. This is one of those weeks where you're going to say, okay, this is kind of the culmination of all of the work that you've been doing for the last 90 days. This week and two more weeks, and then we're going to really see what your finish line looks like. And so when you have weathered the storm and you have been very clear with yourself about what you want, what you're doing, and you're visualizing every day, like I hope that you are, and saying, I can do hard things, right? I hope that you're making that a priority for you and taking time every day to imagine what it's going to feel like when they call and tell you to come pick up your first Mary Kay career card. After all, that's what the purpose of this Pace Setters was for, right? To get you on target for cars and into the IQ. And so today, I hope that as you're looking on the next 3 weeks, that is your mission. At the very least, to be on target by month end and in DIQ. And I hope that these classes and inspiration and things have really been good for you, that you have felt empowered and excited and refocused and re-energized. Some of the messages that I've gotten from you guys have been just that. And I appreciate your feedback. Feedback is really important to me. So I like to hear what you're learning. I like to hear what you're focused on. I like to hear, you know, your obstacles, but that you overcame them. Watching you guys turn in your homework and be focused on this finish line has really been so empowering to me as your leader, to really see that you have truly run the race and you have truly been exactly on purposefully intentional day in and day out and day in and day out to make sure that you finished and what you started. I got a message this week from another national sales director, Crystal Trojanowski, and she told me that she had just started her Mary Kay business 6 years ago when I was debuting as a national sales director at Seminar 2010. And Crystal sat there as a brand new consultant, and she said, watching you debut on stage with your husband and watching him be so proud of you that his eyes were filled with tears. Matt just kept looking down and blinking, hoping that nobody would notice, right? And there's 10,000 people in the arena looking right at us on the Jumbotron. That we stood there and I held my little one-year-old son, who was in his little suit and a tuxedo. He looked all cute the whole time we were at a seminar. And she said, Holly, when I sat there, a dream was born. You guys, Crystal's not part of my area. She's not even tied to me in any way, shape, or form, but she was tied to my finish line without me knowing it. So I always say you never know who is tied to your finish line. You guys, finishing what you start is so important because there are people who you will recruit on the last day of the last minute, of the last second of a goal, who this business will change their life forever. And they can be a huge piece of your own finish line puzzle. Because your vision is clear, because you're focused, because you're working, because you're daily intentional on what you're doing, someone else's life can be revolutionized because of your Mary Kay business. So my senior national sales director, Anita Conley, recruited Elaine Williams. She was the last person she needed to go on target for her car. And Elaine, for several years, just ordered enough to stay an active consultant. Elaine recruited a couple of other people in the meantime, and one of those people was me. So see, today, Elaine, I don't even know if she's still an active consultant with Mary Kay, but guess what? She recruited a national sales director because her recruiter had a goal. Can you imagine? Who out there is tied to you finishing what you said you were going to do? Who out there's life can be changed, touched, molded, shaped? Whose children's lives will be changed because of the Mary Kay opportunity? I want to share something with y'all today from this book. I love this book, written by Anne Newberry. She's a national sales director emeritus. Many years ago, Marsha Grabity, one of my Canadian national sales directors, was at a guest event hosted by national sales director Daylene White. She approached Daylene and said, I'm just a step away from becoming a national sales director. What would be your advice to just get it wrapped up? Daylene only asked her one question. May I see your date book? The date book says it all. Of course, I realize not everyone carries it around like we did back in the day, but the message is clear. We are in a retail sales business, and every time you help put product on a face or sell the product, you are on your way to showcasing. Showcasing a pink car, showcasing a diamond bumblebee on your shoulder, or even your name being showcased in our Applause magazine. Remember, the greatest danger in dreaming and setting goals is allowing someone else to determine what happens to them. That's why you have to believe in each person until she captures your belief and makes it her own. You have to see far beyond what she sees today and help her realize what she can do tomorrow and for a lifetime. You know, another thing that she talks about in this book is there is no replacement for the Mary Kay party. So many people have tried the shortcuts. They've tried to find a replacement. They try to do something else. They try to do it another way. They try to look at other direct sales companies and make and do what they do. But I want to tell you something. Ann Newberry was highly successful in Mary Kay, had 16 national sales directors debut out of her lineage. You guys, that's really powerful. I don't even know what she retired with in earnings. I don't even want to know. I mean, just unbelievably high level of success in her company. And she says, it's our Mary Kay party. It's what we do and it's who we are. And I just thought, wow, hashtag we get to party. My job is hashtag I get to party. What would happen if every time you held a Mary Kay party, you took a picture of you with all the girls there and hashtag I get to party? What would that say to the people that are around you? It shows that you're having fun, that you're living life to the fullest, that you're making money, that you're happy, that you're successful, that you're fulfilled. You guys, when we do Mary Kay the way it was designed to be done, it is so fun and empowering and enriching. It is so exciting. When we go around and we're not taking time to book every day, but we think about it, and we're not taking time to get leads every day, but we think about it, we're so exhausted and we're not rested from failure. We don't ever feel rested and at peace when we're not achieving what we're called to do. You know, my senior national, Anita Tripp-Rutten, always said, I'd much rather be exhausted from success than rested from failure. And I could not agree more. You guys, today, I want you to hear my heart when I say there is one truth that you need to know. Success is hidden in your daily routine. Until your date book looks like a pink Cadillac sales director, a Mary Kay sales director, a cruise driving director, a cruise driving DIQ, or a cruise driving consultant, a free car driver, until your date book looks like what hers should look like, you will continue to stay in this place of discouragement and frustration. So what happens is you've got to have enough. You know, some people tell me, well, gosh, I got a name today, and a name is great. But until you continue to get name after name after name after name, day after day after day after day, and you learn the process of Mary Kay. One of my sales directors, Paula Parker, has taken on the 21-day challenge to do 10 booking calls a day for 21 days, no matter what. Seriously, say no matter what. Because she's had craziness going on, for real. She's missed one day since we started talking, and I told her today was the day she had to double time and do 2 power hours today. So she texted me this morning and told me exactly what time her power hours were. She's been giving me the results and being accountable, and you guys, that's what this is about. Is finding out your success formula. What does it take for you to feel successful and accomplished? And I'll tell you right now, your success is going to be tied to affirmation and accountability. Where are you getting your affirmation? What are you saying in your own head? What things are processing through your brain? You know, a few years ago, I did a speech and I told a bunch of people that if I was married to myself, it would be considered emotional abuse and I would divorce myself because I'm so hard on myself and I say such mean things to me. But you know what? God created me exactly like He wants me to be. And if I'll just learn in all these years of Mary Kay, I just had to learn to look in the mirror and love that girl who looked back at me and love her just the way she was. Love her just the way she was, and to not wish I had different gifts or want other people's lives, but to want my life and to be grateful for the cards that I had been dealt. But the one thing I know is this, you can change your reality because you've been handed the card of Mary Kay. You've been handed an opportunity called Mary Kay Cosmetics where you can write your own story. You can have an incredible story too one day that people across America will read. That it will stop people in their tracks and them say, wow, She really did do it. She said she was going to, and she really did. You guys, so many times in my business, there have been people who were naysayers, discouragers. They were the ones who wanted to hold you back. They're the one when you're running, they want to stand on your cape, right? Because we all in Mary Kay run around with a Superwoman cape on, right? Yeah, it's pink and sparkly, of course. So every morning when you get up, I want you to think about putting on that cape, and you can do anything. You can be anybody you want to be. Your kids can have the most incredible mommy if that's what you want to be. They can have the mom that's at every ball game, that brings all the brownies, that bakes all the cakes, that does everything she wants to do. Why? Because you get to be in control. But let me tell you this, everything worth having is worth working for. And there will be times when you will choose this over this. There will be times when your Mary Kay business needs to take priority for the day. There will be times when you're finishing a big goal. Like my hope for you is on April 30th, that you make a decision, that you decide to fight like you've never fought before. You guys, we got a couple weeks left. We got two more pace setters until we're finished. And I want to tell you, it's been amazing. It has just been absolutely incredible to be with y'all and to get your feedback and to see that you like the checklist. You like being told what to do. You like a weekly plan. Guess what? Your director can help you set a weekly plan for yourself. If you're struggling and you're kind of nervous about what's going to happen when Paysetters is over, guess what? Your director will give you the plan. Work on this week. Get back to me. Then I need you to focus on this. But you guys, 25 leads, 15 faces, 8 interviews, and 10 calls a day, that's going to be what you're going to do week after week after week after week from here forward. So let me tell you one more time. Number one homework this week is fill out a bubble sheet. Make 10 calls a day, at least Monday through Friday. That's 50 calls, you guys, 50 calls. You're going to have some bookings from 50 calls of being consistent. But you've got to continue to get 25 leads every single week. Because if we're not getting those leads week after week after week, we run out of people. And when we run out of people, we get nervous and we get scared because there's no one left. But you guys, baby girl, every 6 seconds, they're in college because they were in my classroom and I was a third grade teacher. They're in college. Guess what? They're customers now. They're potential recruits. They're hostesses. So when you stay in Mary Kay long enough, it all comes full circle. The little girls who are the daughters of your customers are now big girls who can be on your team. But you got to weather the storm and you got to keep fighting for your dream. Put on your cape every day and think, I was made for greatness. I was born to do this. I was born to be successful. You guys, we have a job to do in our Mary Kay business. And that is to not sit and flounder, but to stand and fight. My mantra this year is warrior on. Warrior on. Just continue to fight when you're frustrated. Continue to fight when you're scared. Continue to push and fight when you don't feel like it. But warrior on. I write it all over my notebooks. I write it all over my date book. Warrior on. It's time to rise up and be strong. You guys, we are made so tough as women. Do y'all know this? We are so tough. We are so tough. So it's time to rise up and warrior on. Fill out your bubble sheet. If you haven't registered for May Race and Fearless, get that done. 25 new leads, and you got to do 15 faces and 8 interviews. You guys, when you get in the habit of continuing to do these 2 to 3 to 4 to 5 parties a week, right now for your car, 2 to 3 parties a week is going to earn you a Mary Kay company car. You are going to earn a car. And the dealership's going to call and say, hey, Holly Lowe, we're so excited. We have a Mary Kay car here. When do you want to come pick it up? And you're going to get to take your family to the dealership. And you're going to stand beside this trophy on wheels. And you're going to get to pull away from that parking lot. I cried the whole way home, 45 minutes away from my dealership. And I thought, Lord, I am so undeserving of something so wonderful. But you know what? God has so many great blessings in store for us if we will just do the work. Stay the course and warrior on. I hope you guys have an incredibly powerful week this week. I can't wait to see the amazing things that you're going to accomplish. I can't wait to see that you continue to fight through every temptation to be lazy, every temptation to be discouraged. Fight through the temptation to not do what you're called to do. Fight through all of those things. Rise up and warrior on. You guys have a powerful day today.